Hey everyone, it's Nicholas Wilton at Art to Life, and I wanted to show you my letters. I just got to see this Art to Life thing up there. These are pretty cool. These are letters that this guy up in Portland gets from like buildings that have fallen down. You know, like I think the E is from like Wells Fargo. You know, like these are those big, huge letters on the side of buildings, and they tear the buildings down or the businesses move. And he has all these letters, and I spent about an hour and a half inside of this big kind of weird funky store choosing these Art to Life letters. And I don't like the two so much, but anyway, I'm going to paint them a color and play around with them, but I think they're kind of cool. I'm trying to remember what I was going to say. Oh yeah. So what are the things that I've been talking about in the program that, you know, I in workshops and online programs, I'm helping artists, you know, move through content and learn new stuff. That's what we're doing as artists. But certainly when you do a course, when I do a course, I'm just like, okay, I'm going to take this pile of information on. I'll do it. You know, it's an online course, or it's go to a workshop, or whatever it is, whatever, anything you're doing new. But this has come up a lot. This comes up in workshops, right? So I'm presenting these ideas, and this is especially true for beginners, but almost anybody who is moving through content. That, and I didn't invent this. Is there's these four stages of learning, and I'm trying to remember them. But these were developed in the 70s. This is not anything, you know. This is just something that I really resonate with, and many of you watching might know them. But there are these four stages of learning that you go through. And the first one is called unconscious incompetence, meaning you really don't know what you don't know. So as a beginner, you might stumble into an art class and it's like, it's so fun. You're just playing with all these colors. It's really exciting. You go to an art store, you know, and you don't even know how good your work is. It's just like, whatever. It's like a child. They're just enjoying it for the moment, which is kind of a great state to be in. But then you try to start learning stuff, and that's the second stage, and that's called conscious incompetence, meaning you then kind of are understanding that what you're trying to do, you're not very good at it, and that's a tough stage, right? Because you know enough to know what's good or what you would like, but you can't do it, and so you start comparing yourself, and that's a really, really hard place to be in. I mean, I see it in workshops. It's like day two and a half in a workshop. It's like week five in a 3-month online program. And I just want to talk about this, that is a hard place to know that you don't know and you don't have anything, you can't get it yet, but you know you need to, or you know, you understand that you can't do it. But you don't want to stop there. And that's where most people bail, because it sucks. You don't want to stop there. You just have to understand, but this is the steps you have to go through when you're learning new content. If I'm learning guitar, I've got to go through those. If I'm everybody, these are the steps. If you can just push through that second stage, then you enter, it's conscious competence, meaning you're starting to get, you're starting to understand, you're starting to become competent in something, and you're getting awareness, and you're starting to kind of get it. It's kind of like, it's half working, half not. In this stage, you're getting some feedback, and that's great when that starts happening. It's like, oh my God, that's kind of starting to work, and then it all falls apart, you know, and especially in art making, and especially with the content I'm giving, it's pretty, you know, there's a lot to it. And so, but you get these moments where it's working, and then it falls out, and that understand that that's what that stage is, but you're starting to get it, and you're going to be in your left brain a lot, because you have to be, because you're trying to remember. It hasn't been ingrained yet, and that doesn't feel so good, especially being for making art. You know, the way we make art in our old way, before we're trying to learn something new, it's more spontaneous, it's freer, it's how we've always been working. So this is just the natural cycle of it, but conscious competence starts to work and starts to feel a little better. And if you can hang through that, then you're going to be coming into unconscious competence, where it starts to becoming ingrained and you don't have to think about it so much. And that's the ultimate goal, right? And then, you know, you kind of get that going for a while and that feels really good. And the work starts to shift, it gets easier, it gets better. And then after a while, you're gonna need to learn something new and start the whole cycle over again. But I just wanted to point it out that, you know, identify where you are in this. And if it's not going so well, just understand that that's, you have to do that. You can't skip steps. You have to go through that really crummy stage when you're learning new material. And we're all learning new material all the time. We should be anyway. If you need, you need your work to change, you know, but especially for people who are just trying to get into this for the first time, just remember, you know, you're going to be going through these stages many, many, many times, and that's just how it looks. So I hope that helps, especially for those of you in kind of teetering in that number two stage. That's just how it goes, you know, but it's just what you have to do. So anyway, I'd love to hear your comments on this, and hope you're having a great Sunday afternoon painting or sculpting or photographing or playing with your dog, whatever. Okay, thanks.